Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm gonna be sharing with you guys the 5 apps that will turn your small business into a big one. So let's just hop right into the apps because I know that's why you clicked this video. The first one is obviously Shopify. Now the reason I say Shopify is because a lot of people are choosing to start their businesses on Wix, WordPress, on Squarespace, and any other website builder, but I'm gonna explain why Shopify is the absolute best to start a business on. With WordPress, unless you are a coding expert, you're gonna get yourself all tongue twisted and tied up, and a lot of people never even get off the ground simply because they don't know how to use the website builder. So WordPress is strictly for experts. Don't even stress yourself out. Wix isn't terrible, but let me tell you something. When you scale your business, you're gonna wanna switch over to Shopify eventually, especially if you're a product-based business. One thing I strongly dislike about Wix is that they do tend to overcharge for a lot of their basic features that are just included already in Shopify. Now, Squarespace, I don't really have any negative feedback on. The only reason why I wouldn't suggest Squarespace for a beginner is because, in my opinion, Squarespace is geared a bit more towards bloggers, vloggers, and those with service-based businesses. If you have a large catalog or intend on having a large product catalog, you're really gonna wanna move with Shopify to begin with. Not only do they have some amazing integrations, which, by the way, this is not a paid ad. I just have been using Shopify. I have 2 stores through the platform, so I know it front and back, and every day I'm still learning about all the different integrations that they're coming up with. I love that they have a POS system and a separate POS app. So if you want to sell in person, it's going to be ideal for you to not only have the Shopify app, but the Shopify POS app. And they also have their own card readers. And not to mention that the templates are really easy to navigate. Honestly, it just feels like a lot of the free apps are all you're gonna need with Shopify. So I believe I pay about $30 a month to use the Shopify platform that I need. They do have different plans, starting from $9 all the way up to like $200. But for the basic stores, I mean, to get you started, you're really only gonna need to spend $19 to $30 a month with Shopify. The next app you're gonna need is Scannable. Now, I know you guys have heard of Evernote. Scannable is their sister app, which basically allows you to use your phone as a scanner. This is super awesome because you can turn real documents into PDF files with just your phone. I like this app a lot because it's free and it turns even the craziest and oldest of documents into really crispy looking PDF files, which is important for me because you don't want people to know you're using your phone, you know? You want people to think that you have all the capabilities that a high-tech office would have. So Scannable is definitely one of those very useful apps. The next app is one of my favorites, and it's what I use to make my YouTube thumbnails, Typorama. Typorama is a free app that allows you to make flyers, thumbnails, and put text and watermarking on any photo you choose. It also has preset sizing and aspect ratios, which is why I use it for my YouTube thumbnails. When you're using the app, you can change between different fonts and styles, but also you can add shadows, outlines, different colors, so it really allows you to do a lot. Oh, and the best part about Typorama is that it does come with a full stock photo catalog. So let's say you need a stock photo, but you don't want it to have all those watermarks. Typorama is really great because there's a free catalog of all the same stock images. Now, I believe I'm subscribed for the Typorama Pro Edition, which is only a few dollars a month. Again, none of this is sponsored. These are real apps that I use, but in my opinion, it's just a lot more simple to use than some of the more sophisticated apps like Canva. The fourth app you're going to need if you intend on growing your business is QuickBooks Online. You could choose the QuickBooks Online or the QuickBooks Self-Employed route. Now, let me just explain the difference really quickly because QuickBooks has so many different, like, you're just gonna be so confused if you don't know the difference. Self-employed really tracks your mileage, your expenditures. If you were to earn a 1099 at the end of the year, self-employed is gonna be for you. YouTubers, perfect for 1099s. If you have a product-based business, you're gonna wanna go with QuickBooks Online because it doesn't so much track your mileage and your personal expenditures, but it gives you a profit and loss statement. And it also tracks customer transactions, sales receipts. So you see the difference between the two. One is really for product-based businesses, and the other is really for service-based businesses. So if you're a YouTuber or if you're a creator, go with the self-employed option. But if you have a product-based business and you're on Shopify, go with the QuickBooks Online option, and both of them have mobile apps. The last app you're gonna need to turn that little business into a big one is LumaFusion. LumaFusion is a mobile video editing app. It has a lot more features than iMovie, even on your computer. It only costs about $30 to $40 for you to sign up and download the LumaFusion, and I believe it's just a one-time purchase. So it's so worth it, and it's a lot cheaper than downloading Adobe Premiere Plus or whatever it's called. There's so many other apps and video editing software that are very expensive. I remember I used to be a big fan of Final Cut Pro, but back in the day I couldn't afford to spend $200 or $300, so my cousin suggested LumaFusion, and for just $30 at the time I downloaded it, and I was able to do everything I wanted to do on my phone. I like to use a stylus because sometimes the buttons can be a bit small, but you can move titles around, you can add borders, change fonts to the titles, you can add transitions, you can layer different effects. Most of my videos that are on my YouTube channel and Instagram are edited in LumaFusion. Even if you're not a creator, you might be thinking to yourself, why is she telling me about this video app? Like, I sell shoes. You still need these editing capabilities for your ads. And once you get into producing ads, I think all of us can agree that we know the difference between a good high quality ad that we want to click on and a crappy ad. So those are my top 5 picks for apps that I use to turn my little business into a big one. If you liked this video or found it helpful, please give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to leave a comment if you have any other app suggestions that could help make our business even more profitable. All right guys, we're ending this video. Until next time, and don't forget to follow me on all social media platforms. I'll link all of them below.